Let's talk about representing characters here. So what is character set? Character set actually contains all of the character symbols that a computer can use or represent. So for example, each character has a unique number, binary number, or hexadecimal number, yeah. And each word is actually represented by respective character set. So for example, the word hello. Each character in the word is actually represented by its own unique code. And each code, they actually store in the order of the word. So for example, hello has a code of 111, E has a code of 222, L has a code of 333, and then 333 again, and then O has a code of 444. It doesn't really matter. It means that for each character inside the word, it's actually represented by certain unique code. Yeah. So let's look at different types of character set. Yeah. So first of all, we will have ASCII. And then this actually represents letters, numbers, and characters found on a standard keyboard with 32 control codes. So later on, I'll be just showing you some demo of what control code is. And then ASCII is actually only 7 bits. It actually only contains 7 bits. It means that out of these 7 bits, it only can contain up to 128 possible characters, ranging from 0 to 127, since 127 is actually the max number that it can represent in 7 bits. So for example, character A has a binary number of 65. Yeah. So it means that in ASCII perspective, let's say you want to represent A, you use the number 65. So let's talk about extended ASCII. So what is extended ASCII? Extended ASCII actually contains both ASCII and non-English characters. So let's look at one example. So for example, character C here is actually represented by the number 169. And actually it contains 8 bits. It has 256 possible characters. 0 to 127 actually coming from ASCII here. And then we have the new character is 128 to 255. Yeah. But there is some problem with extended ASCII. Yeah. For example, there are different standards on how 128 and 255 are being used in different countries. For example, Japan are having different characters from 128 to 255. And then France is also using different characters from 128 to 255. Yeah. So to solve the problem with extended ASCII, we will have another character set. Yeah. So let's talk about Unicode. Yeah. So Unicode actually includes characters from ASCII, extended ASCII, and unique number for every character regardless of platform and program. So it means that the characters will always stay constant regardless where you are and which platform you use and which program you use. So it actually solves the problem with extended ASCII. Yeah. So in general, it contains 1 to 4 bytes per character. So just to have a recap, 1 byte actually means 8 bits. And actually contains higher storage per character. So this is also a downside of having Unicode. Yeah. So to do a recap, you can think of it this way. ASCII is like the first version. So it means that it only contains 7 bits and actually represent control code and English characters. Then later on, different countries want to use their own symbol and character. So we come up with extended ASCII. So once we come up with extended ASCII, we realize that, oh, there is different standard from different country. So how do you actually solve that? In the end, we say, oh, how about we just come up with Unicode, which actually have a standard for all the platform and programs. Yeah. So this is, you can think of this like version 1 and then version 2, and this is like the version 3 or the final version. Yeah. So let's look at some example for ASCII. Yeah. So let's start from 0 to 31. And this is more like the computer control code as we mentioned before. So if we look at this, this is a table, we have the decimal 0 here, all the way to 31, so these are all mainly computer control code. You don't really have to memorize this table, but this is mainly just for sharing. For example, 8 stands for backspace, and then 9 stands for horizontal tab. So let's look at ASCII from 65 to 96 here. So for example, this is a table, we have 65 all the way to 96, and then 65 stands for A, 66 stands for B, and it goes all the way to Z, which is 90 stands for Z. Yeah. So you don't really have to memorize the table. The reason why I share this slide is just for your understanding, because just the words itself you can't really visualize, but now you should understand better. It knows that actually, for example, decimal 65 just stands for A, and then 90 stands for Z, and etc. Yeah. And now let's look at extended ASCII, which actually represents some special characters. Yeah. So if you look at this, it's 174 to 205, and actually different countries will have different characters. For example, this is, I'm not sure this country, this is for which country, but 174 stands for R here, and then 197 stands for some special A symbol here. So this is mainly for extended ASCII. Yeah. And finally, let's look at Unicode. Yeah. So this is part of a Unicode because Unicode table is too big, so I'm just extract part of the Unicode table for you to see. So for example, this is the Unicode table. Just bear in mind that all are actually using hexadecimal codes. So for example, all these are actually hexadecimal instead of a binary or decimal. Yeah. So for example, let's represent character A. So can you actually find character A from the screen? So character A is actually here. So it means that to represent character A in Unicode perspective, actually we are just using the code 004 and then 1 here. So this is how we get here. It means that this is hexadecimal 0041 to represent character A, yeah.